Rottweiler Vlogs, episode 133. Mizzo and Mack out here in Dallas, Texas at the Dawg Life facility with another amazing video. Please make sure you like, share, and subscribe. It's very important that you give the video a thumbs up as it helps the video's position in the YouTube algorithm. And we want to give the video as much visibility as possible. And be sure to subscribe and hit the notifications bell.
My name is Misha Dunbar. I am from Tallahassee, Florida. I just recently relocated to Texas, Dallas, Texas, about a year and a half ago. I attended the University of Florida for my undergraduate and veterinary studies. And then I did an postdoc residency fellowship at the University of Michigan. And I actually specialize in laboratory animal medicine. So I don't do general practice, which this would be considered. So we're running a vaccine clinic here at the Dawg Life. So I'll tell you in a second how that came about. But from Michigan, I actually started my career at the University of Minnesota, Minneapolis, Minnesota. And was there for about 4 years, and I just recently relocated down to Texas. And so I work in research, basically. So for me, doing something like a vaccine clinic on the side is fun because in research, I work with a lot of scientists and investigative staff. Doing this kind of stuff on the side is fun for me because I still get to meet owners and talk to people and educate. So we focus on preventative medicine. So primarily vaccines and then heartworm preventative and treatment and
all that good stuff.
Yeah, all that good stuff. So just general knowledge type stuff. One of my younger resident mates, she was working down here and a position was opening up in the department that she worked. And she thought I would be a perfect match. So she called me and told me to apply, basically. And at the time, I was living in Minneapolis, Minnesota. And if anybody was up north or around 2018, there was that polar Arctic vortex where the temperature was extremely cold. There was actually days that it was colder in Minneapolis than it was in Antarctica. And me being a Florida girl, I realized it is time for me to move.
Yeah.
It was time to go. So Dallas was sounding much, much better. And actually, like as I told you, another job opportunity came up in Boston, but I chose Dallas because I was tired of the cold. So it just all worked out. And randomly, I was introduced to Cassandra at Dawg Life through a mutual friend actually that boarded her dog here. And one day they just got into conversation and Cassandra was giving her her idea of starting like a clinic, and she actually wanted to start a full service clinic, but she really wanted to have a black veterinarian, and she's had some troubles with trying to find someone, and my friend just kind of went off, and even though I don't work in private practice, she thought it would be a good fit to introduce us and see what we could do. And so what we came up with, instead of starting a full service clinic, we started just a vaccine clinic for healthy pets that we'll be doing every other Saturday for 4 hours, and that we could both service her clientele that already come here for boarding and grooming and training, and then also people in the surrounding neighborhood, because we're trying to break through to some folks, because I think that there's not many veterinary clinics in this area towards the south side of Dallas. So another big part of what we're trying to do is also educate folks to make sure that they are vaccinating their animals and monthly heartworm flea preventative.
Being around all these Rottweilers here, I'm pretty sure that you've heard, I guess, the stereotypes of how they are. Have you seen some of that here, or is this the complete opposite? You're seeing like the gentle giant.
Yeah, so unfortunately they do get the stigma of being, you know, super aggressive dog breed along with like pit bulls. And so many places do have breed restrictions. We've actually had folks come in to say like, you know, I tried boarding my rot or larger animal dogs somewhere else and they wouldn't allow them. So that's why a lot of people end up flocking here, because they also breed Rottweilers here. And I will say it does become kind of like that nature versus nurture and how they are brought up and how they're trained. And of all of the rots that I've seen here, everyone has all of them have been very well mannered and trained. And just like you said, they kind of are gentle giants. So they've been great. Every other Saturday from 10 to 2, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. At the 2971 Logan Street facility. And you can actually go online to dfwdawglife.com and schedule an appointment. And then we also will take walk-ins as well, but we kind of prefer appointments. And then if you have questions, you can always email dfwdawglife@gmail.com. And dog is spelled D-A-W-G, just so you know, so not the regular dog. But 10 to 2 every other Saturday.
Nice. I appreciate you taking the time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, a lot of places won't accept unneutered dogs for boarding, and because Maurice is a breeder, he understands that not everybody wants to neuter their dog. So that's a benefit for us to bring him here, because he understands that.
Yeah, my name is Gary Lee. This is Draco, Stronghouse of Lee. He's out of the Cold Lounge. Well, back in the day with the style of Rottweiler, you know, nothing had changed, you know. We were more used to dogs with the with the dog tail, but as we grew in progress, we're more of the import pedigree, so we have the tails, you know. And I'm a firm believer of well-bred Rottweiler. Well-bred, you know, strong, you know, together, you know, dark markets and everything, but the breeds came a long way. This came a long way.
Yeah. One of the bloodlines that you have is Nicola's Lion, correct?
Yes, sir.
And that's something that you and I have in common. That's something that you and Fombi have in common.
Exactly.
What is it about that kennel and importing from that kennel specifically that you like?
Well, one of the main things with this is the big bone. Solid. The big bone is solid. And the head structure. You know. And you know, that's one of the things that really draw me to that. Because his dog, I mean, his father, Zeus, and Nicola Lyons, he's beautiful. He's beautiful. He's a showstopper. He's a showstopper. So. That's one of the things, you know, solid big bone.
How do you feel about Mauser?
One of the top breeders around, top guys around. You know, he is.
Prior to me finding out about Mauser, the only link that I knew to him was Japanic.
Right.
And then I think I found you.
Right.
Other than that, I really haven't seen too many Mauser offspring here in the States. Would you agree with that?
Yes, I'll agree. Now, I have one. I have one. Econ Hector, he's an offspring of Mizzo, and he's beautiful. I've won best of breed him twice, best of breed, so he puts out beautiful offspring. This is Leo, Stronghouse of Lee, he's out of my offspring, and his mother is out of the Elstein bloodline also. Elstein is a real strong bloodline out of Croatia, real strong, and the markings and the drive of these dogs are outstanding. They're very good working dogs, and stud service. If you want to get in contact with me through my Facebook, you know, or even your messenger, then we can go from there, you know. But the love of Rottweilers, that's my passion for Rottweilers, and to me, they're the best in the world.
So I have a Ogg Park Forest Macho son. He's going to be my keeper pup. He's currently 8 weeks old, and his mother is Nova of Bond Dog Life. The drive on him is amazing. His nerves, he has amazing nerves. I've been doing a lot of socialization with him already, and I haven't really seemed to find anything that just, you know, makes him break or, you know, makes him back down or shot down. A lot of courage on this pup. So he's gonna stay here with the Dawg Life family.
Nice.
As far as the Rottweiler meetups, so far they've all been great. I just love the opportunity to get all the Rottweilers in the area all under one roof. It's a lot of amazing looking dogs that you would never know, you know, until everybody start coming together. When I first start getting my dogs, I end up meeting Gary, and I see his dogs, and I'm thinking that, you know, I got the most amazing looking Rottweilers around, and I see his dogs, and it's like, wait, you know, it's some other people I agree with some amazing dogs too. And that just made me want to bring everybody together more and more.
My name is Kaylee Finger. This is my dog, Callie. She's a real good dog. She has great obedience, and she really knows how to follow directions. in the quiet setting. She's 11 months, like 2 years, a year, next month. Her dad is Macho, and her mom is Nova. She's part of Dawg Life, and yeah, I like to learn about how to take care of dogs, and it's also a good experience, like knowing the responsibility of having a dog.
Nice. Well, I appreciate you taking the time to talk to us, and you're definitely on the right track. You stay close to the phone, but you're going to be all right.
Yes, sir.
Derek Timber, this is Leo, Strong House of Lee. Passion came from my uncle growing up back in Louisiana. He used to breed Rottweilers. He gave all his family members one, so had my Rottweiler for 13 years, and it was precious. Kind of got away from it as I grew. Came to Dallas. 8 years to today, met Gary online, met to Rottweiler meetup, and me and my wife talked about it, and we was trying to figure out what type of dog we kind of, the look of the dog we wanted. I knew I wanted the big, strong looking dog, nice chest, nice big bone head. I ran into Gary, saw Draco, and I just fell in love from there, and I just knew I wanted to have an offspring from that bloodline.
DFW_DawgLife. That's DFW_DAWGLIFE.
Nice. I appreciate you guys taking the time. Thank you.